the Bible. Have you read it? Let's go to Genesis. One man, one woman. You know what? It's Adam and Eve. It's one man, one woman. It's not Adam, Eve, Julie, Susan. I don't think God likes Susans. Because here's the deal. If you go ahead and do this, you will be sleeping with another woman's husband. You will be the whore of Babylon. So, we've all heard this before. It's one man, one woman. Well, usually we hear this from Christians. Granted, we hear from people sometimes that are not Christians, but the vast majority is religious Christians. Well, they're trying to do a good thing. So, let's give them the benefit of the doubt. The problem is that most Christians don't actually study their word that much. A lot of them that study the New Testament don't study the Old Testament, and the ones that do study the New Testament, sometimes they don't even study that very often. Now, the problem is they're right and they're wrong. So the first thing is, remember that it is one man to one woman. That is the covenant. One man, one woman. But what they're failing to miss, the second part of that equation, is that a husband can have multiple covenants with multiple women and have multiple wives. So we see this in the New Testament, and when Paul talks about espousing to one husband, espousing you in the irregular plural, which means you, all of you to one husband. And we see it in the Old Testament where it talks about men of old, the patriarchs of the faith, having more than one wife and never being condemned for it. But they want to go all the way back to Genesis. And in Genesis, we see polygamists, and we also see Adam and Eve. We see both there. And if they're not willing to accept or understand that both are there, you're going to have a tough time. But get them to the point where you agree with them. They're right. But they're also missing a piece. So there's some advice, and have a great day. This is Gene KF with Polygamy HQ, and this has been Polygamy Talks.